Hello there and welcome back. This tutorial is going to be about the Redis product, and this is an open source key value based in memory data store. So I think this pretty much sums up the advantages and disadvantages of this, let's say, product. But what's most important about this is that it has a nice Python module. And since this channel is all about Python, I would like to show you how I have set up my, let's say, demo environment in which I am trying out stuff that I can do via Python with the Redis data store. So let's get started. What I did is to not to mess up my machine. I have installed a Debian virtual machine and I would like to start it. So this is a base installation. It has one CPU cores and gigabytes of memory. Now, what I can, let's say, do is to try and SSH into this machine. So I have checked the IP address. It's kind of static. And what I can do is SSH into my host with the following command. And let me get the prompt for you. So there we go. So this is the Windows feature that you can enable. So you have an SSH server and SSH client installed, and you do not need to use PuTTY or .NET SSH from PowerShell or whatever. You can just use the native SSH, which is provided. So what I would like to do is to navigate into the downloads folder and get the latest tables download URL, and there you get the following. It's about 2 megabytes, because these are just source files, and what we can do now is to extract this compressed file, and there we have the Redis folder. So we need to change the directory into that. And before we do anything, we need to install 2 packages. Install the make and the GCC. These are needed so that we can compile these source files into actionable items. And then we can, let's say, run our Redis server. And until this gets ready, what I would like to show you is how I have prepared, let me get the prompt, how I have prepared my, let's say, virtual environment. So Redis demo, and this should take some time because I have now an older laptop. This was my laptop before I got to work for the company called Lego. It was used long, long, long ago, so I spent a lot of time polishing it. So we have installed our dependencies for the build. What we need to do is issue the make command with the malloc argument that is going to point to libc. This is needed because by default, it needs the GE malloc header file, and if you don't issue this command, you need to run the update src. So ls-l, and there is a script which is supposed to update the gmalloc, but never mind. So make malloc equals libc. Until this gets ready, what I would like to do is activate my Redis demo virtual environment and pip install the Redis module. As you can see, it was already installed. before, so it didn't need to go out and grab the sources from the Python package index, but it used the local cache. So in such cases, when you already have this package downloaded, it is going to just check if there was any change to the specific package. If there wasn't any, then it will reuse the cached version. So let's import our Redis module. And now what we can do is issue the dir command. And here we can see that there is this Redis class, and this Redis class is what we are going to use. So if I issue the redis.redis help command, you can see that this is a class representing the implementation of the Redis protocol. And if you just simply try to think about it, what you need to do when you want to connect somewhere in a general way, you need to specify some kind of protocol, a host, and a port, and that's all. So this is basically all we need to specify here, because there is no password protection or authentication set. So now what I want to do is to modify the Redis conf file, and here there is a line that says which interfaces to bind. And if we want Redis to listen on all interfaces, we need to comment this one out as the statement goes. The second one that we would like to do is to navigate into the source folder. And here we have the Redis server. So if I ls this one out, we can see that this is an executable. And we can run the server the following way. This protected mode, no argument is needed, because the client is going to complain if we do not disable this protected mode in a way that we want to use the client to connect. So it is now ready to accept connections. So redis.redis host equals 192.168.229.55. The port is 6379, and the connection that set, we need to set it the tutorial and say Python is the best. And if we want to get this key, then all we need to do is connection get tutorial, and we can see Python is the best. So basically, this is all I wanted to show you. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Thank you for watching.